Good afternoon. Thank you so much for taking the time to come out and listen to my presentation that I am doing for my senior project and my nursing course at Columbia State University. And I am Tiffany Marchie. Today we will be discussing promoting flu prevention in the workplace. As you know, starting August, September, we were dealing with the beginning of flu season. And right now, we're getting close to where it's almost the peak. We've been into the schools, and we're encouraging all of our coworkers to receive the flu vaccine if they have not already. There we go. It began with a sneeze. Something as simple as, you know, just sneezing, which we probably do at least once a day. You would be amazed at how many germs we put into the air just with one simple sneeze. Did you know that there were 53,000 people last year in the United States who died from the flu? Educating yourself on what the flu is and how it spreads is more important the understanding of how important it is to prevent the flu. Prevent yourself and protect yourself from the beginning of the flu. That's the flu vaccine. So imagine touching the door handle, your keyboard, your mouse. Because, you know, at some point in time, we don't know who may be in our office, or if the cleaning lady comes in there, she's dusting, and she happens to sneeze, that's what we have left on those surfaces. And even as simple as the toilet handle, which we, you know, we all, I'm one of those that I'm very cautious about touching on. If I can get away, I try to do it with the tissue, or I try to do it with my foot until it's safe. So thank God for automatic toilet. Our objectives here, the goal will be to increase the number of staff members who receive the flu vaccine yearly, as well as to initiate a survey that will be given yearly that will be used to gather information on the amount of people that take the flu vaccine. And that will give a percentage of people. I don't know if that will be used because we haven't got to that point yet if this will actually be initiated, but this is my thought in doing this, that it should be. Everyone should get a yearly survey with these when they've gotten the flu vaccine. For the ones that choose not to get the flu vaccine, of course, we need to educate them on the importance of the vaccine and ways to prevent from getting the flu. That's how we should all live every day happy, well, and ready to go. No one's sick right there. And they're at work and ready to provide service. Okay, the reason for this project is it was an issue that came near and dear to my heart because I do have a low immune system and my immune system is compromised due to illness. And so it's important for me to protect myself by getting a vaccine every year. So I feel that as my coworkers, it's important for you to receive a vaccine as well. Because the last thing that I want to do is receive the flu because you didn't get the flu shot. And if I do have it, at least I know that I got the vaccine, and that will lessen the amount of time that I'll be sick, if I get sick at all. Also, it's important just to, you know, if you don't think about me with the low immune system that I have, to even consider worrying about the person next door to you, or the people in the building, or if you happen to end up sharing an office, you know, at some point in time, the person that's in that office. And also by promoting the flu prevention in the workplace, and not only protect you, but also others, as well as your family. You know, if you have kids, you don't want to catch something at work and take it home to your husband or your children, or even your elderly family, or anybody that you come in contact with. that may be in your compromise or have something that you need to do. Gentlemen, who I found research on, published this article in 2013. It was titled Intervention to Increase Vaccine Rates in the Workplace, and that included education. That he even said incentives. Working for the state, I don't think we're going to get any incentives. having easy access, and of course, competition with rewards. I guess, like, you know, for the first person to get the flu vaccine and something like that, we give a prize. But like I said, until the tell, we're not going to get that either. Assessment and feedback. And just other ways to just kind of get in there and get people to increase the vaccine. And then Sullivan, who published something in 2009, did comprehensive vaccination strategies that included making vaccine available at no cost in the workplace. That's even, you know, if you had insurance or didn't have insurance, the workplace would offer those vaccines at no cost. Along with just, you know, encouragement and promoting why it was so important to get the vaccine. Evidence for change. Influenza is very contagious. If influenza is the virus from the flu. And as I just stated earlier, how simple it is just to touch a door or your mouth, or like I said, the toilet handle, how you can just pick that up. Even the refrigerator, when we go and get our lunch. You know, everybody doesn't wash their hands, and that's one of the biggest ways to help prevent from getting any type of sickness, which is food. You know, the food is keep your hands off and keep them out of your face. Because if you like me, I have a tendency to like to touch my face a lot. And with that, because it's an upper respiratory tract disease, it can cause death, as you can see with the 50,000 people that have died from this, especially in high risk people like myself. And of course, immunization is the main line or the main defense. Or healthcare workers to prevent spreading it, you know, among each other. And that will decrease the amount of sickness. Because if you'll notice in our winter months, whether it be through any type of viral infection, whether it be stomach bugs or the flu, you see more sickness in the cold months because we're in such close contact with each other. And of course, we like to keep it nice and hot. And there's a campaign, the seasonal flu campaign, which is put in place to help reduce the transmission of the flu. And right now, believe it or not, there are some healthcare agencies that are mandating the flu vaccine. A lot of your hospitals, some of your doctor's offices, it is not a choice whether you get it or not. If you're going to work for them and in their facility, you have to have. We sent out the survey when the question was brought up about how many people had received the flu vaccine. The survey was sent out, and out of all 12 counties, it was sent to every employee, and I only received 43 days. With those 43 that were returned, 35 of those people had already received the flu vaccine for the year. And right now we are in the middle of November. And 8 of them have not received it yet. And the thing that I found about the survey that was just really different were some of the answers that I got of why people had not gotten the flu vaccine. And I'm going to read a couple of those to you. One person stated that the reason she didn't get it was because she had a aunt or close family member that got the shot and then they got upright. So that was a reason for not getting through that, because of that rope that made them stop it. Another person stated that because I don't take medications or vaccine of any kind unless they're absolutely necessary for the healing of my body. Not thinking, well, if you get through, your body won't, it'll be sick, and it's going to take, depending upon, a week to 2 weeks to heal, to be 100% from just being sick all that time. And another person stated that she used to get the flu when she was in the Army, and then she would get sick from it every year. So she hadn't taken it in 8 years because of the experience she had when she took it. And I found that with a lot of people, especially when I work at clinic, when you talk about it, when you encourage or you offer the flu vaccine, the first thing they say is, I don't take it because it's going to make me sick. Or I don't take it because when I take it, it makes me sick. And that's when education becomes important, because you have to tell them, okay, a lot of times when you introduce something that is foreign to the body's defense comes into play to figure out what that is. And so you may get to the point where you may have some, you know, a low-grade fever. You may even feel a little achy. Or you just have that feeling or sensation when you just don't feel good. And then hopefully in a couple of days, you won't have that feeling. But if you compare that to feeling like that and being sick in the bed for a week, having a high fever, no appetite, chills, headache, shaking. Me, myself, I would rather have the little achiness for taking the flu vaccine and being sick for 1 or 2 days than being sick for a week or even ending up in the hospital. And then there was another one that I thought was really stood out, that the only reason she took it was because she started working in public health. And she realized that in order for her to be able to be an example, she had to start taking it. Whereas years before, she wasn't taking it. And I thought, well, you know, that's a good thing, because at some point in time, at public health, someone educated her on the importance of protecting herself as well as the people around her. So, the basic thing would be, as you can see, these people are your sick co-workers. You have the guys in the meeting blowing their noses. Even though the lady here, there's a lady here, she's covering her mouth with the tissue because she sees the guy in the middle who obviously looks like he probably got fever and chills and everything else going on. But this lady is just disgusted that he could either sit there and be that sick and take them all of them. So these are things that I see happen all the time at this time of year when I'm in a meeting. You have the people that mean well. And you know, yes, neither in the Army is good, but if you're sick, stay home. I'd rather you be there for one day to protect yourself and get better, as well as to protect me just by staying at home. Okay.
Sorry about that.
So my recommendations would be to get the education on food banking first to make you aware of what not only the benefits but as well as the sciences, which I told you earlier may be a low grade food bank. If we even sorting that the site if you get it. And then know that the vaccine does not cause the flu as the myth that a lot of people say. But I don't think we're gonna find any way to get rid of that because as long as people are gonna take it, they're gonna always feel like if I took it today and I'm sick by Saturday, it had to be the flu vaccine. Also prevent the spread of the flu virus with hand washing, cover your mouth with a cloth or two. And of course, like I said, stay at home. Most people look happy. They're happy because everybody in their office has been vaccinated. Nobody's spread any type of germ. And they're just glad to be once again working. All right, here, the expected outcome of this project was to eventually educate you. As well as we're going to increase the number of staff members who receive the flu vaccine year. And then also, we're going to ensure to make sure that each year you're educated on the flu virus as well as the appointment of the vaccine for those that choose not to get vaccinated. Those of you that are doing it every year, you're already ahead of them because you know the importance to protect yourself as well as your family. And of course, in conclusion, receiving food vaccine not only protects you, but it protects others that you may come in contact with. So it's important to get educated and vaccinated. As well as, you got to remember, like I said in the previous slide, please wash your hands. Please encourage your children to wash their hands. Right now, because we're in the dry months, you know, like I said, we come in contact with a lot of things and we touch a lot of things. So like I said, the hand washing is the most important thing. After you eat, of course, after going to the restroom, I'm even a little more paranoid where I will even wash my hands after I touch certain things because they tend to just feel a little nasty. But like I said, just please just make sure you wash your hands. Are there any questions? And like I said, at this last slide you'll see, she's doing the right thing by receiving the food vaccine from her doctor. And she's very calm here, so you know the pain is very minimal because she's sitting there and she's looking. So if it takes that for you to look, then that's okay. And I want to say thank you for your time and for listening and encouraging me during this time to complete this project. And we're going to each year continue to get our food vaccine and keep ourselves healthy, as well as being good co-workers for me, because you're going to be vaccinated and not get me sick. All right, thank you.